Hello friends, I welcome you all for our third lecture on Introduction to Thermodynamics of Systems in Mechanical Engineering course. In last lecture, what we have covered, let us revise that part. In last lecture, we have studied what is thermal engineering, what are the subcategories of thermal engineering. After that, we have started studying thermodynamics, definition of thermodynamics, then what is a system, what is surrounding, what is boundary, what are the types of boundary that may be real boundary or imaginary boundary. Then types of system, which are an open system, a closed system and a isolated system. Then in order to distinguish between open system, closed system and isolated system, different examples we have considered. You might be remembering we have prepared a cup of tea. While listening further lecture, you can enjoy that cup of tea. Let's go ahead. Now, how to study any thermodynamic system? Any specific approach, any specific process is there in order to understand this thermodynamic system? Let us study that part. As far as our thermodynamics is concerned, or any study under engineering or science is concerned, there are basically two types of approaches, which goes as microscopic approach and macroscopic approach. Now let us study this microscopic approach and macroscopic approach one by one. Let us start with microscopic approach. Microscopic approach means what? Study of any system at a molecular level. It means if I have to pass any judgment regarding behavior of any system, then I need to study the each and every molecule of that system, or the behavior of each and every molecule of a system. We have to study, and after that we can pass any judgment regarding behavior of that whole system. Now, what is macroscopic approach? In a macroscopic approach, we are not going to study that system at each and every molecule level. Instead of that, what we are going to do, out of that total system, some specific part we are going to study, and depending upon behavior of those parts of that system, I'm going to pass judgment regarding the behavior of a system. Now, in order to understand this microscopic and macroscopic approach, let us take an example of our class. Now, if we have to pass a judgment regarding a particular class, then according to microscopic approach, what I need to do? I need to study the behavior of each and every student of that class. And after studying the behavior of each and every student of that class, I can pass a judgment regarding the behavior of a class. This comes under the microscopic approach. Now, instead of studying the behavior of each and every student, I have selected a specific group of students and I have studied the behavior of that group, and based on that group's behavior, I'm going to pass a judgment regarding the behavior of whole class. That comes under the macroscopic approach. As far as our engineering is concerned, we are not interested in microscopic approach, or we are not going at microscopic approach. We are only following the macroscopic approach. But as far as our quantum physics is concerned, or science related part is concerned, there we are going to study the microscopic approach. Now, what is thermodynamic state? Thermodynamic state means what? The condition of a system. Now, next comes the properties of a system. Now, property of a system means what? Any quantity which gives the characteristics of that system, it is nothing but a property. Or in another words, we can also say that property of a system is any measuring parameter for the behavior of that system. Now, which are the properties of the system? Let us take few example. That may be pressure, that may be temperature, that may be volume or mass, density, etc. Now, as far as these thermodynamic properties are concerned, these are of two types, intensive properties as well as extensive properties. Now, let us study what do you mean by intensive properties and what do you mean by extensive properties. Let us start with intensive properties. Now, the intensive properties are the properties of system which are mass independent. It means what we can say, with respect to change in the mass of that system, the quantities or properties of that system are not going to change. Those properties are nothing but intensive properties. Now, what are the extensive properties? These properties are mass dependent. It means what? If I am going to change the mass of any system, the properties related to that system which are going to change with respect to change in mass are called as extensive properties. Now let us take a question. Density, whether it is an intensive property or extensive property. In order to have the solution of this question, let us assume a room whose pressure is capital P, temperature is capital T, area is capital A, volume is capital V, mass is small m, and density is nothing but rho. Let us divide this room into two equal parts. Now, the pressure of first half part will be P by 2, second half part will be P by 2. Similarly, temperature will be first half part it will be capital T, second half part it will be capital T. Area of half room, first half room will be A by 2, second half will be A by 2. Similarly, volume will be V by 2 and mass will be M by 2. Now, as we know the definition of density, density is nothing but what? Mass per unit volume. So let us calculate the density of total room first. It will be density of total room, rho will be mass of total room per unit volume of total room. It will be rho is equal to small m upon capital V. Let us give it as equation number 1. Now let us calculate the density of half room. The formula for density of half room will be one and the same. That will be mass per unit volume. But here the volume and mass of half room is going to change that of the full room or total room. Now let us call the density of half room as a rho 1. It is equal to mass of half room will be m by 2 divided by volume of half room will be v by 2. Now let us cancel the 2 at a denominator and 2 at a numerator, then I can have rho 1 is equal to small m upon capital V. Let us give it as a equation number 2. Now let us have a look at equation number 1 and equation number 2. Here we can find right hand sides of equation number 1 and 2 both are equal. Then we can say that the left hand sides are also equal. So what we will get here, density of total room that is rho is equal to density of half room that is rho 1. From this what we can say that with respect to change in the mass of a room, there is no change in the value of density. So we can conclude that density is mass independent. So what we can say, the properties which are mass independent are called as a intensive properties. Have you got the answer? Density is intensive property or extensive property? It is a intensive property. Now, these thermodynamic properties will possess either state function or path function. There are two types of function, which are state or point function and path function. Now, let us study this state or point function and path functions in detail. Let us start with the state or point function. The quantities or properties which are possessing state function or point function are independent on path followed by the system. and which are the examples of the properties or quantities which are possessing state or point function are temperature, pressure, enthalpy, etc. Now let us study the path functions. Path functions are possessed by those properties or those quantities which are dependent on path followed by the system. It means what? With respect to change in the path followed by the system, the properties or quantities of that system are going to change. Those are possessing path function. The best suitable examples or examples of the quantities which are possessing path function are heat and work. Now let us study what is energy. Energy is nothing but what? Capacity to do work. Let us start with different forms of energy. How many forms of energy are there? Almost four forms of energy we are going to focus here, which goes as potential energy, kinetic energy, internal energy, and enthalpy. Let us start with the potential energy. Potential energy is nothing but what? Energy stored due to its position. In order to understand potential energy, let us take an example. The water stored in a water cooler is nothing but what? That water is possessing potential energy. Now, what is kinetic energy? Kinetic energy arises as a result of motion. In order to understand kinetic energy, we can take example vehicle in a motion, or we can calculate the kinetic energy by using the formula 1/2 m into v square, where small m is nothing but what? Mass of that system, and v is nothing but what? Velocity of that system. Now what is internal energy? Internal energy is nothing but energy which is a result of molecular vibrations. If you are going to take any object, it is composed of n number of molecules, and these molecules are continuously oscillating or vibrating about some mean position except at its absolute zero temperature. So how we can calculate the total energy of a system? Total energy of any system is calculated by total energy of a system is equal to potential energy plus its kinetic energy plus internal energy of that system. Mathematically, how we can write capital E is equal to mgz plus mv square divided by 2 plus capital U, where capital E is nothing but total energy of the system. Then small m is nothing but mass of that system. G is equal to acceleration due to gravity, as we are going to consider this experiment or this equation we are writing for Earth. Z is nothing but height of that system, and V is nothing but velocity of that system, and finally capital U is nothing but internal energy of. Now what is enthalpy? Enthalpy is defined as total heat energy content of a system, or we can also define enthalpy as algebraic sum of internal energy and flow work. Mathematically, how we can write small h is equal to capital U plus P into dV. Small h is nothing but here enthalpy, capital U is nothing but change in internal energy, plus P is nothing but pressure, and dV is nothing but change in the volume, or P into dV we can call it as a flow work. Now let us revise what we have studied up till now throughout the lecture number 3. We have started our lecture with the revision of lecture number 2, followed by if we have to study any thermodynamic system, which approach we need to follow. There we have studied microscopic approach as well as macroscopic approach. In order to understand these two approaches in detail, we have taken an example of our class. followed by what is the state of a system, followed by thermodynamic properties, which are intensive properties or extensive properties. Intensive properties means mass independent properties. Extensive properties means mass dependent properties. Here, in order to understand whether density is an intensive property or extensive property, we have taken an example of room. And finally, we have concluded that density is an intensive property. After that, we have studied state or point function and path function and the quantities which are possessing either state function or path function, followed by study of energies and different forms of energies. In different forms of energies, we have studied potential energy, kinetic energy, internal energy, and enthalpy. I hope that you have understood the part which we have covered till now. If you have finding this information useful, please do share it among your friends. And finally, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you.